it really over now? Did we win?
Defense unit, do you read me? You need to fall back!
Not happening, Himbari. This is our home, and we mean to keep it safe. We'll fight to the last man and the last round if we must.
Hey, we've even got time for a little chat. We're fine. We're good.
First unit, circle around to support their flanks. Let's go!
Yes, sir.
Blood unit reporting. We're jumping in on this fight. Let's go, team!
Blood, you must withdraw for bias factor check. You've been out there for too long.
Captain, I have a portable bias factor kit. If you want to keep fighting, we're with you.
Everyone, look there! More origami!
Cradle, Blood, respond! A second wave of reinforcements is emerging from the tree. You'll have to hold them back.
No way. There's so many. This is gonna be fun.
We see them. Cradle, engage at will. Take down anything you can.
Blood Special Forces now joining the battle. Target at will.
All right, if we're doing this, they're the ones going down. We keep moving, keep them on their toes, and we will get through this. Come and get it! Julius is still alive. He's waiting for us to rescue him. And if he can fight, so can we! Just shove off!
We'll clear out every one of these origami. Then everybody will understand. Finally, they'll see that Julius isn't the enemy. We'll do it. We'll slay him. Every last one!
The last time we had to leave behind one of our own, we swore to return. In that moment, we knew helplessness. We had strength, just not strength enough. This time, we won't fail. Never again! We won't give up! We'll never give up!
Can you hear me? It's Tatsumi. The origami are... They're all running away.
We see it on screen. It's like they're heading back to the tree from all over the Far East.
That blood power. I know it.
Me too. It's his. It's Romeo's.
So, were the God Arcs functioning all right out there?
Not quite. They just stopped working for a little while. What happened?
When the Origami Horde turned away, it seemed like everyone's God Arcs stopped working.
Rumor has it there was a power outage over the entire branch.
In a manner of speaking, all Oracle cells in a wide range shut down temporarily.
Something emitted a blast that froze every Oracle cell in the immediate vicinity. Anything that runs on them went down in a flash. A few origami just crumbled when the blast hit them. Their cells necrotized and they were just... gone. The origin point of the blast was right here. The only conclusion we've been able to come up with is that somehow Romeo's blood power activated to save you.
Romeo's power?
I so totally knew it was. It had to be Romeo.
Then you all felt that same power?
Yeah. was the same one we sensed when Romeo died. Julius came back alone. I could never forget that feeling.
Romeo's God Arc has been dormant since he died. We've been trying to access it, but to no avail. And all of a sudden, this happens. You all unleashed your blood power in that battle. That might have caused some resonance with whatever power remained.
You mean his God Arc is still working?
It may sound strange, but it's almost better to say, still alive. It's gone dormant again, but there is power there.
Still alive?
A God Arc is essentially a man-made origami. It lives, it breathes, keeping pace along with its wielder. There is a chance, however small, that Romeo's soul still lives on inside his God Arc. But I have no option but to seal it away. It's dormant now, but if it awakens again, it could lash out. Another unseen power outage would be a catastrophe.
I'm sad to say, but she's right. Romeo's power to repel Oracle Cell activity is dangerous at best, and could be fatal at worst. I swear I will continue to study his God Arc. I may need your help in the future, but I know I can always count on you. We have news about the Spiral Tree. A Tempest made of activated Oracle Cells prevents us from getting anywhere near the inside. Just as before, if Blood can't find a way to do it, then no one can.
Agreed. None of our control devices have nearly enough capacity to stop the storm. Could we harness the force you suggested in your report concerning the recent power outage?
You mean Romeo's blood power? Potentially, I guess. It may be able to deactivate the storm cells. There's still so much we don't know about blood power. Who knows if we'll be able to control it?
Who knows indeed? This is owed more consideration then. Thank you for your help, Doctor.
Director, I have something to say, if I may speak freely.
It's the only way, isn't it? I didn't want to put you in that position. First, I must beg your forgiveness. These catastrophes that have befallen us all may be laying at my feet. I apologize. Still, there is a chance to fix matters. I cannot do it alone. I'll need each and every one of you. You have my thanks. To begin, we must verify all we know. Dr. Rachel managed to deceive Cujo. She asked him to bind the Emeth device into the tree. The device awakened her. Now her will holds both Julius and the Spiral Tree in her sway. Once more, she aims to unleash the apocalypse. Unless we can rescue Julius, she will succeed. And that brings us to our plan of attack. Please, observe. As before, we will carve out a path and secure it with the control devices. Our main obstacle is the constant vortex of active Oracle cells that guard the entrances. We believe we can use the same power that forced the Origami mass retreat to get past. The resonance from Romeo's God Arc attenuates Oracle cells. It can even slay weaker Origami. Using the power bound up in his God Arc, we'll dissipate the Oracle cells and enter the tree.
We have no control over Romeo's God Arc. His power can't tell the difference between Origami Oracle cells and our God Arcs.
Livy does have control, or rather, she can. In time, she can bond with his God Arc and gain some measure of command over. What say you, Director Sakaki?
All of Blood will serve as a support unit for Corporal Livy, so she can give her complete focus to controlling Romeo's God Arc. Captain, as with Julius's Arc, your Evoke skill may help her to draw forth some latent powers. I want you to stay by her side every waking moment.
We will range into the tree, find the source of Rachel's will, and eradicate. Once our mission is complete, we will find a way to save Julius. Only he can stop the apocalypse. Any questions? A team dug through Cujo's logs and journal entries. They revealed a mass of unreported meetings with Dr. Rachel. We're still sussing out the details, But right now it seems more than likely she abused his affection for her. Rachel was clever. She brought him into her scheme as a failsafe to ensure that even if she died for the cause, an apocalypse would rise. Pull it up on screen. As you can see, Cujo secretly installed the Emeth device in one of our control safeties outside the tree. It was triggered or timed to release during the dedication ceremony. You all saw how that ended. I suspect the doctor's primary goal was to stall Julius, thus creating a path for Cujo himself to enter. His secondary task was to compile a device that would serve to reconstitute Rachel's will once he had broken free. Once deployed, it did just that, locating and rebonding what remained of Rachel. Once the entire construct was under her control, she was able to seek out another source for the apocalypse.
I can tell you what I know about the Emeth device. Upon examining Cujo's terminal, I discovered blueprints for a modified version of the device. It began as a form of the autonomous control system developed for unmanned God Ark soldiers. But it can do far more than just that. You see, the entire concept of the Emeth device was Rachel's. It was meant to stall Julius and recompile Rachel's memory once she was consumed by the tree.
Romeo's blood power repels Oracle cells. It shuts them down.
It affects anything with Oracle cells, right? So, God Arcs and bias factors are just as vulnerable.
Precisely. God Eaters are not exempt. It is a perfect double-edged blade. If we're to stand any chance at all, it is with Livy holding some measure of control over his God Ark.
A few final matters to attend to. We need far more than Fenrir intelligence. HQ, the Far East, and Cradle, all are necessary. We'll need outriders in the tree, a secure base camp, and reliable supply lines. What say you?
Cradle is well versed in building satellite bases. That should serve. Later on, we'll have Alyssa meet with the old man to figure out the details.
We're facing a threat unlike any before. Thank you for all you've done.
So cool!
It is rather wondrous. It's difficult to tell in here, but we should be almost halfway up the tree. Gil, are you all right?
Huh? No, I'm fine. Really, fine. Just not so big on heights.
Really? Wow, Gil. Huh? What's that singing? It's you. Tell me, why have you come to this place? That's some greeting for an old friend. So, why don't you answer me this time? Why have you come to this place? It seems to me that you abandoned my Julius here. You left him to tend to your spiral tree, forgotten in your sacred land. You claim to care for him, but you let him linger here. If you didn't truly wish to part with him, you should have told him long ago. Perhaps you should have spoken your mind when poor Romeo was offered up. Alas, if you'd only gone with him, if you'd only gone to his aid, then maybe innocent Romeo would not have fallen so. Maybe then
Julius would not have contracted the Black Plague, would not have coughed up his blood and burned his skin with scars. What of the day when he came to you with shadows upon his eyes and told you he would leave your little family? If you'd done more to stop him then, maybe he'd not have been alone in the Spiral Tree, with the ghosts of Aragami slain, arrayed against him. I tested you, tested humanity. Even if I hadn't, you would still face the same fire. Fools, beyond fools, you have fated yourselves to burn. For every challenge you have faced, you have failed. Time and time again, you could have turned to me. And yet, naught but silence. You were given one last chance. One final opportunity to cleanse this world in peace. And you were still. You waited. So now, once more. Tell me true. Why have you come to this place? You are ever defiant. Oh, my little warrior. So, you have resolved to bring Julius back, have you? Will such a simple thing save this world? To resurrect your mistake? Very well, my children. Your hand is dealt, and fate stands ready. If you desire to take him, you are more than welcome to try. Yet know this. Tearing free singularity from my devouring apocalypse will bring a terrible wrath. It will drown you in conflagration. And all the while, you ponder. Save you. Save your allies in blood. Does anyone else truly wish to see Julius return to your world?
Captain! Captain, are you okay?
Look! There! It's...
Not gonna lie, that reskin looks cool. Cue the music. Yes, kneel before me.
Blood rage is fading, reverting to normal God Arc control. Blood Alpha, you've got to fall back. You're in danger.
Ew, looks like I got too greedy. Cue the music.
Yeah.
remember to get a proper rest before the next.
Hey, what the hell?
You felt it too? That origami's resonance. I'm certain I know it.
Yeah. It felt almost exactly like the captain's blood power.
Hold tight!
Look, what are those things?
Such force! Everyone, hold fast! Livy!
Back to the branch immediately. Nana, can you take hold of Livy? She'll need our help.
Got her!
Gil, cover our retreat. The last thing we need is an ambush.
On it.
Far East Branch, come in. We're falling back to the mouth of the tree with injured. Send an escort team to meet us.
Thank you for your report, Captain. Do you have a moment to spare? I've been hoping to speak with you. Has Corporal Livy told you anything of her past? Livy. She was raised at Magnolia Compass Orphanage by Rachel and Leia. You could almost say she was a test run for Julius. We found out too late that her home for the lost was only a cover to test bias factors adaptation on children. Livy was the first she found that showed any true promise. But Rachel... Rachel named her a failure. Livy could adapt, and well, but not before experiencing violent rejection of the core bias factors. Each attempt drew from her very life. Once Rachel discovered that Julius could adapt with no side effects at all, Livy was discarded. And here I am asking her to continue to sacrifice and bleed to save Rachel's pet team and her beloved Julius. I wish it weren't so. Livy is logical to a fault. In all my years with her, she's never taken action I could not understand. But I don't know why she fights at your side. In the end, I suppose it's of little consequence. All that matters, all that I ask, is that you keep her safe. Thank you, Captain. That'll be all.